everyone, welcome back to another YouTube video. In today's video, we're going to talk about what are the first things you need to learn if you want to become a data scientist. Data scientist has been a term that has been thrown around in the industry, specifically in the tech field in the recent years, especially after the Harvard study called it the sexiest job in the 21st century, which is debatable and definitely a topic for another video. But you can see that it has gotten so much attention because of that. And also there are obviously like some good sides to being a data scientist. So because of that, there's a lot of information on the internet. Some is good, some is okay, and some is just does not make sense at all. So I am going to share some of the things that have personally helped me transition and what I have learned from my experience. For those of you who don't know, I come from a non-tech background and I became a self-taught data scientist. I went to business school, then transitioned to working as a data engineer, and then became a self-taught data scientist. If you have not watched my previous video where I talk about my journey, I'm linking it here. So make sure to give this video a watch and see, you might find it useful. So before we jump into the video, make sure to give this video a thumbs up to help with the YouTube algorithm and subscribe to my channel if you would like to hear more from me on the data topics of data science as well as career related topics. So talking about what is the first thing you need to learn? Well, let's step back a bit. So in terms of becoming a data scientist, first thing I would suggest to figure out, data science is an umbrella term. And the term data scientist is used very liberally that it does not mean the same thing to one person versus what it means to the other person. And the same stands for the companies that are hiring for data scientists. In some companies, data scientists, they mean applied scientists, a person who is a developer times data scientist. In some companies, a business analyst is considered data scientist. So keeping that in mind, what I would suggest you to do is first figure out where exactly, I'm gonna link this video here where I show that diagram in terms of what exactly you need to do. Look at that diagram, figure out where exactly do you wanna be on that diagram? Do you wanna be in the middle, which is kind of more of like a generalist data scientist? Then there is more technical, which goes into applied scientist. Then there is a machine learning side. And there's more at the bottom, there's more data analyst focus or business analyst focus. So first thing you need to do is figure out where exactly do you wanna be on that Venn diagram. And once you have figured that out, I promise you, your path, your journey is gonna be much simpler. Because if you don't know where you wanna be on that diagram, you're gonna be all over the place. You're gonna be learning statistics, you're gonna be learning machine learning, you're gonna be learning Python, you're gonna be learning tons of other things. Believe me, the data science field is huge and you can easily get lost learning, trying to learn everything. So if you're able to narrow down your focus, able to narrow down what you want to be and then work backward, it's only going to help you. So let's say you have figured that out. And you want to be a generalist. You want to be a generalist data scientist, which is basically somebody who has good business knowledge, has a good statistics knowledge, good machine learning knowledge, and understanding of software development process, and is able to combine, as well as product management, and is able to combine all these together and apply their knowledge to solve business problems. So you have three options. One is you can go back to school, you can enroll yourself in a data science degree program, and you can follow through that program, that curriculum, and then graduate with a degree and build some projects and then look for a job. The second option is you can do that through a bootcamp. Bootcamp is a version, I'd like to think about it in a way that it's a degree program, but it teaches you everything that a degree program teaches you, but in a much condensed fashion. And that's why those programs are normally like 8 to 12 weeks. And those are intense time periods because intense programs because you have to learn a lot during that short time period. So bootcamp is another option that it requires a lot of your attention. So for a degree program, you might be able to do it if you're already working. So you might be able to do that part-time, finish that degree program. For a bootcamp, I feel like it needs your like dedicated attention to be able to get the full advantage out of the program. So those are the two options. The third option is, which is something that I did and a lot of people do end up doing, is going the self-teaching route, and that is through learning through like bunch of courses, learning on your own, from peer mentoring, from doing the work and all of that, everything combined, watching YouTube videos. And I am primarily going to be focusing on that last bucket today in terms of the self-learning. And for those of you who are trying to do that, what is the first thing you actually need to get good at to be able to get your journey started? So for me personally, what was super, super helpful, and I would highly encourage you to consider that, is starting with, and I know a lot of people start with Python, like there's advice out there that says that start with Python. Some advice says that you go and do R. Some says like go learn SQL. I think those are absolutely okay, but that's okay advice. But let's step back a bit. SQL, Python, R is a tool to apply data science. It's not the data science by itself. So if you really want to learn the knowledge, learn the field, I would suggest you to start with statistics. For those of you who are already working as data scientists, you would agree to this, that the statistics is the fundamentals of any data science roles. Whether we're talking about a data scientist generalist, or we're talking about a machine learning scientist, or we're talking about an applied scientist. So statistics are the fundamentals of any data science role. So the first thing I would suggest you to do is start with statistics. And once you have figured that out, then you can add more to it, whether that is Python or whether that is going more deeper into machine learning, a skill set, but like starts with the basics, start with statistics. And when it comes to learning, how do you learn that? There are multiple ways to learn. If you have taken statistics as part of your schoolwork, like I think that's pretty much enough. There is not much to statistics. It's just the basic fundamentals and it doesn't change much. So whether you learned it from your curriculum, from your course that you have taken at school, or you learn from a book, or you watch a YouTube video and like combine all those concepts together, I think anywhere you can learn. Statistics can be learned anywhere because the concepts do not change. The concepts, the statistics concepts do not change. The teaching style changes from where you're learning from. So I guess like it all comes down to like your learning style, how you learn best, whether that is through video content, whether that is through reading, or whether that is through taking a course. So figure out what works for you and then start with statistics. Build that foundation. And once you have built that foundation, then you can go to the next step. And we can talk about it in the next video, but then you can start learning the coding languages. And I have a lot more to say on the coding languages, which one to get started at. And it's a slightly controversial topic because different people have different opinions on what language to learn. I definitely have my one of my own. So I will definitely share that in another video. But in terms of learning statistics, yes, definitely start there. For me, what was helpful is I started learning statistics. One of the books that my manager recommended me at that time when I was working as a data engineer is, let me show you. So this was, and I promise this is not sponsored, I just found it in my cupboard. And I was like, this is perfect for this video because this is something that I did use when I was learning statistics. So this is a book, Practical Statistics for Data Scientists, by Peter Bruce and Andrew Bruce. So you are welcome to buy it from anywhere you want and learn statistics that way. And then in addition to that, you can watch YouTube videos. There's a ton of YouTube videos on statistics that, and Khan Academy is a great resource for those of you who haven't taken a video on Khan Academy, but it's a great resource for and it does a great job simplifying complicated topics. So what I normally did is I got this book. I did not read everything. I would start like initially with a concept. Then I would read about it in this book. I would read a blog about it. And then I'll watch YouTube videos or Khan Academy videos, which simplify the topic for me further. Because I feel like learning it, just like reading through it one time, it's a little bit harder. I just want to see like how different people would explain it differently. So that's what I would normally do, is I would read it here and then I would go watch a YouTube video. And I learned topic for another video again. I know I keep saying that financial literacy, I became financial literate last year, and that exactly was my route. I would read it in the book. Then if I needed to build further on that topic, I would go to YouTube or I would read a blog and things like that to further my knowledge. So hopefully this was useful. I know there's a lot of information out there in terms of how to get started. This is personally, in my opinion, in my experience, you need to start with statistics. And then you can add on top of it, because statistics is the foundation of data science. So hopefully this was helpful for you. If you have any questions, feel free to leave it in a comment. Or if you have any feedback for me or ideas for future videos, feel free to let me know. All right, I'll talk to you in the next video. Have a good one. Bye.